Can you hear and see any of the differences between these forests? You might have noticed one was lighter than the other. You might have noticed one had more life than the other. You might also have noticed that one of the forests was a lot quieter than the other. Do you know why this might be? The answer might surprise you, and it's all to do with plants. Let me tell you the story of Britain's forests, and it might explain what you see today. Welcome to Carrefour and Wildwood. Thousands of years ago, much of Britain would have looked something just like this. At the end of the last ice age, Britain was covered end to end in lush mixed forest, teeming with wildlife. It was biodiverse. Humans lived alongside this for thousands of years. But over time, our needs changed. We began to use more land for forestry. We began to hunt more. We began to chop down trees for fuel. And slowly but surely, our native forest was pushed back, and along with it, our native species. As Britain began to industrialise, this only compounded the problem. And while we were industrialising at home, the Royal Navy was waging wars overseas at the expense of British forests, cutting it down for timber for their ships. By the early 1900s, Britain's forests were becoming endangered. The need for wood during World War I was so great that forest cover in the UK was down to only around 4 to 5%. This led to the Forestry Commission being founded as a matter of national security, as Britain could not afford to be without its own timber. As a result of this, through the 1900s until now, Britain's forest cover steadily increased. Britain's forest cover now sits at around 13% collectively, and as high as 20% in some places like Scotland. Now, this success is mostly thanks to the type of forests you can see behind me. These type of forests are known as plantation forests, and they're mostly made up of species like spruce, pine, and larch. Now, why are these forests different? Well, let's take a look inside and I can show you and tell you why. As you can see, there's not really very much going on in this forest other than the trees. The ground's quite bare and it's quite quiet. Now that's because of a couple of reasons. Firstly, because most of these trees aren't native. They're not from the UK. They've only been grown here inside the UK for only about, some of them only about 200 years, some of them less, maybe about 80 years. And secondly, these trees are grown for a single purpose. They're like a field of crops. They're like wheat or they're like corn. These trees are grown to be cut down, just like this plot here. Now think back to the differences you see in here. Think, how does this relate to what I've just told you and how this relates to biodiversity? Forests like these are the kind our wildlife needs to be supported. They offer a rich variety of plant species, which encourages a rich variety of wildlife to live within them. These are the forests we all know and love, the forests you walk through and you can hear the sounds of wildlife as you pass. Mixed plant species act as the anchor that underpins wildlife. They make these forests what they are. They make them biodiverse. They make them rich with life. Forests like these, which our most precious at-risk species need, are not widely spread within the UK. I can hear you saying, why does this matter and what can I do about this? Well, let's go back outside the forest to talk some more. And that's because Carrefour Wildwood used to look something just like this. It used to be a piece of land for grazing. Rewilding only began in the year 2000, and planting slowly increased up to what we see today. And the Carrefour project is not the only rewilding project in the UK. There are loads of really exciting rewilding projects all over Britain. And we're going to need more of this if the UK is going to hit its 30 by 30 target. And that's where the UK has signed up to protect 30% of its wild area by 2030. And it can start doing this by promoting and increasing the protection of the wild forest. Plants are superheroes. They do everything for us. They give us food, they clean our drinking water, they provide our air. Without them, we wouldn't be where we are today. But plants aren't only for us. They're also the delicate platform on which nature exists. They're the anchor for the natural world. And that nature is delicate. It's linked in complex ways. We need to promote this nature so we can make sure that Britain is a wild and biodiverse place for generations to come. Go and support your local rewilding project.